beatum Josemaria Escriva de Balaguer, sanctum esse decennius, et definimus ac sanctorum catalogo ascribimus statuentes eum in universa ecclesia inter sanctos via devotione recoli de vere in nomine Patris et Spiritus Sancti.
October 6, 2002. In a solemn ceremony held at St. Peter's Square and attended by more than 300,000 people from all over the world, Josemaria Escriva, priest and founder of Opus Dei, joined the ranks of the saints of the Roman Catholic Church. Every canonization is a celebration for the entire church. In the life of the new saint, the goodness of God shines through. In the saint's words and actions, the faithful find a new model of holiness to follow. What is the message of Saint Josemaria? All men are called to be saints, young and old, men and women, the healthy and the sick, the rich and the poor. All are called to a holiness that is forged through the faithful fulfillment of one's duties at work, in family life, in social relations. There in the midst of everyday life, we find God. After declaring the miraculous nature of Dr. Manuel Nevado Rey's cure, attributed to the intercession of Josemaria Escriva in December of 2001, and after meeting with cardinals, archbishops, and bishops in consistory in February 2002, Pope John Paul II set the canonization for the 6th of October, 2002, in St. Peter's Square. Preparations for attending the ceremonies in Rome then began all over the world. Here in the Philippines, families, friends, parents, teachers, students, and parishioners formed pilgrimage groups. All were brought together by devotion to the new saint.
We wanted to experience the canonization personally.
People will be here to pray, really.
This is one way for me to show my gratitude to him. And I feel that I'm here because I want to represent also the people who love the work, who love Opus Dei in Visayas and in Mindanao.
This is a very important occasion, and I just feel that I have to be here to witness, because I've waited for it for a long time.
He wants me here. Father Escriva wants me here.
Hopefully my family would also be touched.
We wanted to do a pilgrimage and at the same time to thank Monsignor Escriva for the graces that he has given us all throughout the years and helping us and everything.
I just think that it's going to be such an ingratitude on my part if I don't come here, because it has made a very big impact in my life. It has changed my life for the better.
This is going to be also the first saint who I saw in my lifetime, and therefore I feel that we can all be saints.
Really great. We're so excited.
Hindi mo inexpect na kakarating ka dito galing sa Australia.
We'll be praying for so many people back in Los Angeles.
We're excited, you know, at masayang-masaya kami at nakarating kami dito sa lugar nito.
To think that all these people have come to either, yes, to honor the new saint and also to celebrate as a family and to pray together.
We made this sacrifice because it's a once-in-a-lifetime event, and this is really very significant to everyone who is a devotee of Blessed Josemaria.
we felt it was a gift that we had given our children to see.
It affirms my desire also to live a holy life.
I'm so blessed. I really feel so blessed.
The exodus to Rome started on the 2nd of October. The Ninoy Aquino International Airport in Manila and other airports where the planes had their stopovers became witnesses to the strong sense of anticipation that families and friends felt as they embarked on their journey to Rome. The pilgrims, hailing from all over the Philippines, and indeed from all over the world, were united by one other thing: gratitude to the new saint, Josemaria Escriva. Finally, the destination, Rome, a city that perhaps will not be rivaled in history, but more importantly, the seat of Peter. One of the reasons for the early departure of many was to have a chance to pray before the mortal remains of the new saint. Anticipating the large number of people, Saint Josemaria Escriva's mortal remains were moved from the prelatic church of Opus Dei, Holy Mary of Peace, to the Basilica of Saint Eugene. While the excitement of happy reunions was evident, it was easy to sense a different atmosphere as one entered the basilica. After genuflecting before the Blessed Sacrament, each one would kneel in silent prayer before the remains of the new saint, to present petitions or to express gratitude for favors received, and in many cases, for simply being there. At the side of the church, rows of people lined up for confession. Love for the sacrament of reconciliation was one of Saint Josemaria's constant teachings. Faithful to the spirit of their founder, many priests of Opus Dei offered their time to hear confessions. Expecting the large crowd, the organizing committee for the canonization formed an assistance group composed of youth volunteers from all over the world. From the Philippines, 100 young men and women signed up. Each had a different story, but all were brought together by their sincere desire to help out in this historic event.
With all that Blessed Josemaria has done for me, parang I think it's time that I return the favor by serving the people who are also devotees of Him.
Kasi po, pag pupunta kami doon ng personal, marami po kami kailangan gawing sakripisyo.
To volunteer, to help out, kasi marami nga pupunta. Tapos, syempre gusto ko kahit na sa maliit na bagay lang, ay makakatulong ako sa iba.
Oof, it will be tiring because we will have a lot of works and well, I think on the other hand, it will be fun.
Exciting! Siguro at some point nakakataranta kasi most of the people approaching us are Spanish-speaking or Italians and we cannot understand them.
Sometimes it's confusing kasi, di ba, language barrier. You can't communicate with each other. But then, you know, the language doesn't count. It's like, we're one big race.
Masaya, masaya. Dami naming nakilalang from Kenya, from Guatemala, Spain, Italy.
Working with the foreigners is great kasi since we all receive the same formation, no, you can see that there's a sense of openness there, a sense of universal outlook, just what Josemaria Escriva wanted to teach the youth now. So everybody's working with the spirit of service, very excited, no, for the canonization. And it's emphasized very much, no, for the volunteers to smile and really love their work because it's not for them, eh? It's for the pilgrims.
Work there was aplenty for the volunteers. They answered queries, set up chairs, prepared kits, gave out informative materials, kept order in endless queues, and cleaned up St. Peter's Square. They were up long before daybreak and stayed up long after sundown. Their youthful energy and readiness to serve belied their lack of sleep and other material comforts. For them, the grateful smiles of the people they helped and the joy of being able to play an active role in the canonization were more than enough reward. As a way to fulfill Saint Josemaria's teachings about fraternity and solidarity, the project Harambe 2002 was organized. In Kiswahili, Harambe means all for one, and it aimed at getting the pilgrims to donate for educational projects in Africa. The launching ceremony for Harambe 2002 held on the 4th of October at the Auditorium of St. Cecilia along the Via della Conciliazione included some musical numbers. A group from the Philippines was invited to play ethnic instruments.
Excited ako kasi first time kong mag-perform abroad tapos sa room pa kaya parang iba.
Sunday, the 6th of October, 2002. This was the much-awaited day. Pilgrims started coming to the square even before 5 o'clock in the morning. The volunteers were already at their posts. The chairs were all neatly lined in different sectors of the square. In silent prayer, the crowd stayed, awaiting the 10 o'clock ceremony, unmindful of the cold and the darkness.
Live via satellite mula po sa St. Peter's Square sa Roma. Ang aking pong tinutukoy ay ang canonization o pagdedeklara bilang isang santo ni Blessed Josemaria Escriva.
Back in the Philippines, families, friends, and various groups gathered to view the live television coverage of the ceremonies. This made it possible for them to be part of the momentous event taking place in Rome.
Actually, I feel so excited about the canonization and I feel so blessed to be able to come here to Rome to witness it firsthand.
Iba yung talagang nandito ka sa talagang site.
Ah, very tiring, but we're very happy to be here.
Nakatayo rin ng balaibo kasi I've been praying to him and now I'll witness him being a saint.
It's very good to see people from all over the world coming for one particular purpose, which is to witness Pope John Paul II canonize Saint Josemaria.
Pambihirang lakas ang ibinibigay sa amin mula pagkagabi at hanggang ngayon.
Hindi ko maipaliwanag kung ano ang nararamdaman ko, pero lubos ang aking kaligayahan.
The ambience is quite joyous and well, that's how Filipinos.
It seems like it's like a huge gathering of our family.
It was a magnificent journey to be here at the Vatican all the way from Manila. It was really a wonderful experience.
Hindi ako makapaniwala na nandito ako.
Napaka-orderly. Lahat ay very solemn. Nagko-concentrate lahat. Talagang lahat ay yung feel na feel ang nangyayari.
I'm very touched, especially I've seen so many delegations from all over the world, you know, especially the big delegation from the Philippines. I'm overwhelmed and I'm really, really touched and grateful that I was able to attend this very special event.
It was very moving, very solemn, despite the huge number of people.
The feeling is so intense.
I feel so good that most of us Filipinos have discovered the way to sanctity in the middle of the world.
In spite of the fact that I'm an Australian citizen, I feel a great affinity towards the Filipinos, no? and particularly with their devotion to Blessed Josemaria Escriva and their piety. No?
It didn't feel like 2 hours, definitely. Very holy.
It was a great experience. It was so holy. I could feel the warmth and the love that everybody had here.
Napakasaya. Iba ang pakiramdam. Noon dito ko lang naramdaman yun yung pagkakapunta ko rito. Ibang iba.
I felt that I was part of the ceremony and you know it really touched my heart.
I just couldn't help but feel so emotional. Tears are running down both of our eyes.
Ako'y totoong masaya. At hindi ko akalaing ang abang lingkod ninyo sa ganitong katandaan ay makadaro sa tinatawag ng canonization.
Parang you feel like you're floating in a sea of faces. Tapos kahit na alam mo na
isa ka lang dun sa maraming tao, alam mo na you're sharing the same spirit.
The crowd's thanksgiving for the canonization of Josemaria Escriva was best expressed in the spirit of recollection and prayer that filled the square during the ceremony.
Time of consecration came at the Holy Mass. The whole world knelt down. That was a spectacle that was very moving and very touching. Without anybody telling them, almost automatically, they knelt down in the road, wherever they were.
While being a celebration, everyone knew that they had come to Rome as pilgrims to pray and videre Petrum, to see Peter, to be united to the Holy Father and to the whole of Christendom. Thus, their joy overflowed when the Pope went around the square and onto the Via della Conciliazione, as far as there were people to be found. Viva il Papa was the resounding cry, echoing the immense joy of being with the Vicar of Christ. The next day, October 7, a crowd of almost the same size filled up St. Peter's Square for the Thanksgiving Mass celebrated by the prelate of Opus Dei, Bishop Javier Echeverria.
Deo omnis gloria, a Dio tutta la gloria. Vogliamo adorare il Dio tre volte santo e ringraziarlo per il dono con cui ha arricchito la Chiesa e il mondo, la canonizzazione di Josemaria Escriva de Balaguer.
A group of Filipinas was invited to join the many choirs formed for the canonization ceremonies and Thanksgiving Masses.
The events that led up to this, to being able to go to the canonization and also having the privilege of singing in the choir, it was all something that I didn't plan for and God just gave to me.
Ang saya kasi parang instead na nandun ako sa crowd, nandun ako malapit kay Pope sa may altar, tapos kumakanta ako.
Very, very moved to see the Holy Father and to see also the prelate of Opus Dei there and to see thousands and thousands and thousands of people all over the world.
In the days that followed, Thanksgiving Masses for the different language groups were celebrated in various churches and basilicas in Rome. The Filipinos organized the Mass in English on October 8 at the Church of Holy Mary in Trastevere. With the canonization of Josemaria Escriva, the Church has recognized the perennial value of his message on the universal call to holiness. It's a message that has touched and changed the lives of many.
One is very happy. At the same time, you're so proud, okay, that this person whom you've known for, okay, the past 12 years, who had influenced you, okay, who had made that dramatic impact in your life, is proclaimed by the Church as a saint.
Saint Josemaria Escriva wants also other Josemaria Escribas to be guiding other people. We need more saints. We need more heroes.
I hope that more people will get to know the teachings of our Father and that be happy in the process, not they go about their ordinary work.
I would say that it is the holiness of the man, and it is his desire, really, to form holy priest, that somehow make us grateful to him for the work that he has done.
Sabi niya na our work, our holy work, should first make the doers holy, and also should make holy those to whom the work is done.
Well, I'd like to bring home, at least in my to my professional life, no, a greater fervor of pursuing the teachings of this man, no, of Saint Josemaria.
What he was teaching, he was really practicing them to the great amazement and inspiration of all his listeners.
Maski na ano pa ang ating katayuan sa buhay, mayroon pala tayong pag-asa dahil ang Diyos ay kasama natin sa ating trabaho.
I know that now that he's a saint, you know, it's easier for us to teach people and to let them know about him.
The fruits of a bishop or of Saint Josemaria are our Opus Dei priests and lay people in the Philippines who are really making an impact on the spirituality of our people.
Now we have a bright luminary, a bright star in the image, in the person of San Josemaria Escriva. And I hope it will radiate all over the world, you know, the sanctity of this priest.
I was privileged to also have personally met Saint Josemaria Escriva. And in that meeting, he gave me a lot of encouragement to enable me to keep on plowing ahead in spite of the many difficulties that I, from time to time, experience.
If you really are looking for a formula for genuine long-term development of our people, it is this, that we have to learn as a people how to work well, because it is our Christian duty. And that is the best way how we can live our faith.
The days of the canonization had come to an end. And for each one, a new page had been turned. The call to holiness was resounding, demanding a commitment, a personal conversion. Each one was eager to share with family and friends the joyful sentiments of those days and the one clear message of the canonization, that each one can and should be holy in everyday life, like Saint Josemaria.
I'm very, very proud that being a Filipino, that a lot of people from the Philippines came for the canonization of Saint Escriva.
I've never seen so many Filipinos in Rome.
My life would not have been the same if not for Blessed Josemaria and if not for Opus Dei.
It's a unique experience. We've been waiting for this.
We can make ourselves holy in our line of work.
I found everybody praying. It was quiet, very solemn.
This event will remain always in our hearts and in our minds.
It's a dream come true for all of us. So we're basically excited and happy that we're here.
Kinikilabutan ako dahil ngayon lang ako naka-attend ng ganitong canonization.
Napakasaya namin. Ang dami nga palang tayo dito kami. Doon kami lahat pansa kaduluduluhan.
It's so great. I was really blessed.
We're very blessed and we're very overwhelmed.
I was crying from the start. Crying, laughing, and clapping. I don't know what to feel.
Filipino ka pa rin, and your faith is something, our faith is so strong.
My prayers were always answered, and it was always the best answer.